एज ए पार्ट ऑफ अवर फर्म कमिटमेंट टूवर्ड्स ग्रेटर कंस्ट्रक्टिव पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ वुमेन इन द इलेक्टोरल प्रोसेस कमीशन हैज मैंडेटेड दैट एटलीस्ट वन पोलिंग स्टेशन मैनेज्ड एक्सक्लूसिवली बाय वुमेन शैल बी सेट अप इन एवरी असेंबली कंस्टिट्यूएंसी. Our officers have identified even much more than that. There are 690 assembly constituency, but we are setting up a total of 1620 such polling stations that will be totally manned by women staff and the women security personnel as well. This will definitely empower the women, will set an example for others. The women can come freely to cast their votes without any hesitation and without any problem. Similarly, some polling stations will be exclusively managed by persons with disabilities. That will also give a, you know, sense of confidence to the persons and an inspiration to others. We have made special arrangements for PWDs. Commission is truly committed to ensuring a comfortable polling environment to persons with disabilities. They shall be given priority for entering polling booths. Provision made for designated parking spaces close to the entrance of polling stations. Volunteers shall be available to facilitate PWDs. Wheelchairs will be arranged. All polling stations will be having a gentle ramp so that there should be no problem to our persons with the disabilities. We have made arrangement for the postal ballot facility for absentee voters. And three types of absentee voters have been identified. That is the senior citizens with the age above 80+, the PWDs with the benchmark disability, and those who are COVID affected. A polling team consisting of two polling officials along with a videographer and security will then go to electors' house along with the voting compartment and get the electors to vote on the postal ballot. That is just like ECI at the doorstep of the voter. Candidates will be provided a list of such elector along with route chart and a schedule so that they may send their representative accordingly. Therefore, there is absolutely transparency as far as this absentee voter is concerned. We have also given a facility of online nomination to the candidates. This is an optional facility and we would like the candidates should use this facility so that the physical contact can be reduced and online facility can be fully utilized by the candidates who are coming for contesting the poll. Friends, another important issue is the candidates with the criminal cases. Each and every voter has a right to know the background of the candidate. Among other measures to ensure ethical elections, emphasis is also given on mandatory publicity of criminal antecedents. Candidates with criminal antecedents are required to publish information in this regard in newspaper and through television channels on three occasions during the campaign period. Besides this, it is also mandatory for political parties to upload on their website at the home page detailed information regarding individuals with pending criminal cases who have been selected as candidates, along with the reasons. The political party will have to give the reasons as to why this particular candidate has been selected and no candidate without any criminal antecedent was selected and benevolency is not the criteria for the same. And the details will be published within 48 hours of the selection of the candidate and not prior to 2 weeks before the first date of filing of nomination as was done earlier. The details of such candidates will also be available on Know Your Candidate, that is an app developed by the ECI.